Urgent matters need attention. On my daily visits to this little room, I enjoy the view and notice the change in colors through the seasons, time of day or weather conditions, all nicely framed by the window. Inspiration is never far away. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. I have a subject, a view from the window. I print two snapshots of my John's view. In case you are new to abstracting an image, in this situation it is a matter of focusing on the lines and to get rid of unnecessary items like the tree, the cars, the fence, the downspout or roof drain pipe, and so on. I now create a line drawing and blow it up from 20 by 20 to 40 by 40 centimeters. Because I will make several paintings, I create a stencil so I can duplicate the lines easily on every new sheet. This first painting is a simple colored version, more or less based on the colors of the original picture. I will show almost all I paint in this video at a higher speed because the video isn't about painting, but about seeing the possibilities of just one random image and actually making these paintings, as Jasper Johns did. I will show and tell you more about his artwork in a minute. The American artist Jasper Johns used simple, recognizable items as inspiration. He painted a flag and made a second one, a map, and a second one, and a variation of numbers in many different ways. I guess this quote says it all. An example of his artwork shows simple hatching patterns in different colors and directions. I call it number one, the first do something of the quote. On the second painting, he did something else to some of the hatched areas of the first one. And again, now on different parts on the third one. And again, now some parts look like potatoes or rocks on this fourth one. Together these paintings form a series, although at first glance they appear not to be related. I now have this first painting, still resembling in a way reality, but simplified. In my idea, Jasper Johns worked in a similar way as I do now. A very modest but interesting change is to mirror the situation. I don't know many artists who create art in this way, by making a painting for the second time. I can assure you, it feels weird to make this second one. I see this view for months now. So the mirrored one messes up my brain. It feels unreal. Here the two together. A much easier way is to just flip the image on the computer. But by actually making it, investing the time, I notice how different it feels to make the second one. A quick third one. I use the same colors, but I switch their position. I can think of a number of versions and thought of making some more, for instance one with a black sky, but leave it at this one. When making abstract artwork, I like to turn the painting around, noticing my personal like or dislike for each situation. A while ago at my local painting course, we also did this exercise. They made a simple design, took a limited set of colors and made a first painting. And, after protesting for a while, also made a mirrored version. And another one. Some got the hang of it and enjoyed making several versions. See if you can determine which choices they made. Do notice that a simple design doesn't have to be a problem while having fun thinking of new versions. Back to my series. Each time I use the stencils to draw my pencil lines for the next one. But what if I put one of the stencils on a different spot? I look for an interesting position and take green to paint the space in between. And add a second layer of green off camera. By using other colors, as in the beginning, it's easier for me to step away from the original picture. I can leave the rest unpainted or paint it white, but I decide to paint it red. This time I add some titanium white to make the transparent paint opaque. Just to show the influence of a different color, I add extra white to the red paint to create pink. The green also gets a new layer. There's only one problem when painting over a darker layer. The dried acrylics tend to mix a little with the first layer of the yellow. So I apply two layers and perhaps even a third one. It's interesting to paint like this. But unlike Jasper John's way of working, I now end up with just this one painting. It has several layers on top of each other to check different color combinations, but I can't put the different versions next to each other. Luckily, I took the pictures. In the beginning, I showed the series of Jasper John's. In painting number 4, he added wood-like lines. I take the idea and create my variation by first drawing the lines and putting wooden pieces on top of them. Off camera I played a little bit longer and now what appears to be flat turns out to be a 3D piece. But this image can also be disturbed to create yet another version. I used the wooden pieces as a means to get somewhere else while inviting random or chance to join me. So, based on this new situation, I paint some lines using watercolor between the wooden pieces. I could remove some of the pieces to create some more space to paint, but it would interfere with chance and random. In my opinion, this is what Jasper Johns meant when he said, do something to that, and then do something to that. And in case you don't like the outcome, you can always add an extra do something to that. Back to my series. Just a quick black line version. Now a freehand version, turning every straight line into a roundish one. The way I play with the image is up to me. I can stick to the original lining or go wherever my ideas take me. Here, another example. I start painting the lines red and notice the nice contrast, so I only paint the vertical ones and paint over the two horizontal ones. Whether I paint perfect or not, it's up to me. In case anyone doubts, I have this quote hanging on my wall. It encouraged me to paint whatever I feel like. I now paint a version with only the horizontal and vertical lines. I do so because the diagonal lines constantly reminded me of the depth or perspective. Now it looks flat. Interesting. Taking an image and abstracting it by stripping details and stripping even more can lead to interesting line work. But the series wouldn't be complete if I didn't make the other versions. So I make one painting only the horizontal lines and one with only the diagonal ones. One simple painting like this on the wall may look ridiculous, but knowing the story behind it can give it meaning in a series. An interesting question will be, will I take away the pencil lines or leave them on the paintings? In case you have an appetite for more, just click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.